and welcome to this special edition of the Weekend Ahead on WGN News Now as we take a look ahead to the 2022 WNBA All-Star Game, which is happening in Chicago for the very first time. I am Larry Hawley, and if you are tuning in on Facebook, I have all of the comments right here. You want to say something about the WNBA All-Star Weekend or the Chicago Sky's great start to the season, please feel free to go ahead, and we'll try to share them at the end of the show. That, of course, is going to be the big focus, the All-Star Game, finally coming here for the first time. And it began tonight as the WNBA's best arrived for 3 days of activities south of downtown, beginning with the orange carpet as players began to arrive for the festivities. Things get going on the court Saturday with the All-Star Skills Challenge and three-point contest, along with the Nike Tournament of Champions and the girls' Nike Nationals at McCormick Place. That's all part of the WNBA live experience for fans. Then on Sunday, they'll play at the All-Star Game itself at Wintrust Arena at noon. For a long time, Chicago Sky player Courtney Vandersloot, who's been here in Chicago for 11 years, it is quite a moment.
So to have it in Chicago, it is something special. It's different. You know, you never knew what to expect. But I, you know, I'm a little biased, but I think Chicago is one of the best places to have it. So you know, that now that it's here, I think it's going to probably return.
It probably will at some point, but this is the first. Here's a look at those on the Sky who will be taking part in the All-Star Game. Head coach James Wade will be one of the head coaches for the event. That is a first for him, as he's enjoyed a strong career start as a head coach in Chicago. Meanwhile, Candace Parker will be a starter as she appears in her seventh career All-Star Game, doing so in her hometown. She's averaged 13.3 points and 8.7 rebounds per game, once again playing outstanding for the Sky. Meanwhile, three Sky players will be there as reserves in the game. Vandersloot is in the All-Star contest for a fourth time and has made it the last three midseason classics, averaging 11.3 points and 6.4 assists per game. Emma Mieseman is going for the second time to the All-Star game, having gone in 2015 as a member of the Mystics. In her first season with the Sky, the forward is averaging 12.5 points and 5.9 rebounds per game. And of course, Kalia Copper is going to the All-Star game for a second straight year after a breakout 2021 season where she was named the WNBA Finals MVP. Copper is averaging 13.8 points and 5.1 assists per contest. And remember, she arrived a little bit late as she had overseas duties, but still very productive here with the Sky in 2022. Now, All-Star Saturday starts 2 p.m. at McCormick Place with three members of the Sky taking part. Courtney Vandersloot and Azaray Stevens will be in the skills competition. Meanwhile, all eyes will be on Allie Quinkley as she goes for a fourth three-point contest victory. Initially, the Joliet native thought her 2021 triumph would be her last. But with the All-Star Gaming coming to Chicago and many other factors, she decided to give it one more try.
Everybody talking about it to me nonstop. So, yeah, I didn't want to let the city down or my family and friends. And so, yeah, I mean, it'll be fun. It's nice. It's at home and, you know, the whole AAU tournament going on there. Yeah, it'll be a good experience.
Probably will be as she goes for a little WNBA history. Now, the Sky couldn't be doing any better heading into the break. A win over the Indiana Fever on Thursday night in Indianapolis puts their record at a WNBA best 16-6 on the season. That includes wins in 9 of their last 11 games. Head coach James Wade believes that the team is now beginning to find its stride as the full roster is showing results.
We're getting our chemistry down. Roles are more solidified and we're playing with a sense of urgency and we're coming in the form of, you know, who we want to be. So it just takes a little time. And now we have hiccups here and there, but I think we're a more consistent team than we were at the beginning because everybody's been here for a while.
They were 4-3 and now 16-6 on the season, the Sky at the top of the WNBA standings. Now, one of the biggest topics of All-Star Weekend remains the detainment of Brittany Griner in Russia. WNBA players have continued to speak out in hopes of getting her released during the entire WNBA season when it began in May. It will continue during this All-Star game in Chicago. Today, Brittany's wife, Sherelle Griner, expressed her appreciation for the players' support at a news conference held in Chicago.
You guys did not have to go to the extreme measures that you have in honoring my wife this entire WNBA season, from the thoughtless efforts to immediately compensate her salary to immediately lift her up the entire season, it has just been overwhelming for my entire family with joy, knowing that BG's footprint was so big that even in her absence, you still can't miss her.
Brittany will be on the minds of all the players during All-Star Weekend here in Chicago, as certainly the topic of her trying to be released from Russia is at the top of the mind of the league. Now, while the focus of the basketball world will be here in Chicago, it's also going to be a moment for those here in the city to also get a very greater appreciation of the women's professional great game, along with women's basketball in general. And that is a chance to help grow the game. Subria Whitaker of CHGO and Grow the Game joined WGN News Now Sports Talk today to discuss just how big of a moment this is for women's sports here in the city.
So important. And I have to tip my hat off to the league for the timing of everything, and also everyone else involved with a lot of the fans that are coming here, but also to know that tomorrow they'll be doing the three-point contest and the skills challenge in front of the next generation. That's exactly what Growing the Game is about, that the players have someone to look up to and they see them in person, and the fans are able to connect, you know, with players during WNBA Live. I think this is exactly what the league needs to do to build their base, connect with their fans, and connect with the next generation who's going to be the face of the league one day.
How important is it for these young women to see these athletes who are not only performing well on the court, but are also outspoken off of it as well? And how much are they role models as they not only look to play the game, but also grow up here and are the next generation here in America?
It's so important, and it's an opportunity that I'm sure many of, you know, the legends of the WNBA will probably say, I wish we had this opportunity, you know, to be able to see them in a closed practice or a closed three-point contest and have opportunities to have one-on-one time with them and meet them and take pictures, but also connect with them on social media. So like you said, they're not just seeing what they put into, you know, the game and practicing, seeing how they perform on the court, but also understanding their character when they're having these conversations and meeting them and seeing how they carry themselves as a brand on social media and through their community service as well.
How much have you seen the Skies Championship impact women's basketball, girls basketball here in Chicago? And was the credit given to these players maybe a little bit overdue, considering the players like Quigley and Vandersloot and of course Parker in Los Angeles had such success in their careers?
It's long overdue. I've had the pleasure of being able to go to Sky Games when I was in high school, where I went to Morgan Park, and I was able to go to games and see them. And while I wasn't a basketball player, they are what motivated me to do something like Grow the Game, to go into sports, you know, to pursue my passions growing up in the business side. So I think it's important for people to see, even if they're not players, but they just want to be in sports, women's sports, basketball. And, you know, it's so important, and I'm glad that they're able to do it and more people are able to come to games. And part of what we do in Grow the Game is, you know, amplifying the players, amplifying what they're doing on and off the court, and bringing more students and their families so that they can understand that the Sky are here to stay.
Subria also talked about a lot of other topics today when it comes to the WNBA and, of course, the Chicago Sky's great start to the 2022 season. You'll be able to see her full interview coming up on WGNTV.com later on tonight. Want to thank Subria for her time and her insight into a number of topics concerning WNBA All-Star Weekend. Now, as we like to do on sports specials here on WGN News Now, we finish up with a social media highlight. And it comes from the Sky's Twitter account, as Candace Parker giving fans a little hype before the big weekend.
I look for the city of Chicago to show out, as we always do. Summertime Shy is the best. I think it's going to be super special for teammates, our coaching staff, and our home arena. We're ready to show out.
Indeed they are, as you can see, the Sky trying to get people hyped up as they get ready for the WNBA All-Star Game coming to Chicago for the first time. The first major All-Star Game here in the city of Chicago since the 2020 NBA All-Star Game. That was really the last big global sports event before the pandemic would take hold here in America and all across the world. That was in February of 2020. Now, if you wanted to have a comment here on the WNBA All-Star Weekend. We invite you to have it here. We are on Facebook. If you're on Facebook, send us a comment. We'd like to share it either about the Sky, about the All-Star game itself. I know a lot of people excited to have this new event come to Chicago, especially the WNBA Live, the WNBA Live event that they're going to have at McCormick Place. Not only going to include the skills challenge, the three-point contest, but two amateur games as well. I know a lot of the players talked about how important that would be. And as long as we got a couple of minutes here, let's go ahead and take a look at who the Chicago Sky once again have in the All-Star game. We mentioned James Wade will be in the All-Star game for the first time as a head coach. He's had an outstanding run here as the leader of the Sky since he took over in 2019, made the playoffs every year. And of course, Candace Parker, the hometown hero. She continues to perform at a high level late in her career. 13.3 points and 8.7 rebounds per contest so far this season. She is in the game for a seventh time. Now, the three All-Star reserves for the Sky, that's going to be Courtney Vandersloot in the All-Star game for a fourth time, made the last three, averaging 11.3 points and 6.4 assists per game. Emma Mieseman, who came over from the Mystics this offseason, also going to be in the game. She's in for a second time so far for the Sky, averaging 12.5 points and 5.9 rebounds per game. And Kalia Copper, one of the emerging stars in the WNBA. She will be there as well. She had a breakout 2021 season, WNBA Finals MVP, averaging 13.8 points and 5.1 assists per contest. Remember, she got to the team a little late, had overseas commitments, but still playing very well. And then on All-Star Saturday, three people on the Sky to root for. Vandersloot, Azaree Stevenson will be in the skills competition. Allie Quigley, the native of Joliet, will be going for a fourth three-point contest champion chip in her WNBA career. Remember, she thought about hanging it up there after last year, after winning it in 2021 in Las Vegas, but she's going to come back one more time to try to get it done and win in front of the home fans. Well, we thank you so very much for tuning in to this WGN News Now WNBA All-Star Weekend special. Be sure to check out WGNTV.com for updates on the weekend, along with WGN News as well. We'll have updates tonight on Friday on GN Sports at 10:30, and then GN Sports on Saturday night and on Sunday night at 10:30 as well. But online for right now, I am Larry Hawley. Thank you so much for tuning in, and have yourself a wonderful night and a wonderful weekend.